You used to call me on my cell phone. Late night when you need my love. Call me on my cell phone.
Hey guys, so today's video is going to be an updated what's in my bag video. I asked you guys on Instagram if you wanted to see an updated one, and a lot of you said yes, so I had to come through for you guys. And plus, I just saved my coins and got a new bag, so I wanted to share with you guys. So the purse that I'm currently carrying is the Givenchy Antigona bag. I think I'm pronouncing that correctly. I know so many people pronounce it differently, but yeah, this is the bag, and I decided to go with the smooth black canvas with gold hardware, and I really, really love this bag. It's just such a timeless classic bag, and I just think it's absolutely gorgeous. So it does come with top handles and a shoulder strap, and I don't think I'm gonna ever buy another bag without a shoulder strap because it's just so convenient when you're shopping and doing things like that. And I'm the type of person that I like to carry everything in my bag, like literally everything but the kitchen sink. So I decided to get mine in the size medium, and I really, really love this bag. So yeah, that's the one that I'm currently carrying. I know a lot of you who saw it on Instagram asked me if I think it's worth the money. Although it is a little pricey, I do think it's worth it because it's just such a timeless piece that I feel like you'll always be able to carry it no matter what. Just absolutely beautiful. And the quality of the bag is amazing. Like, it has such great high quality that it's definitely worth it. Of course, for the price, you know, the quality should be grade A, but it really, really is. So I really, really highly recommend, like, if you're interested in this bag, you've been thinking about saving your coins for it or whatever the case might be, then I just say go for it because it's just a beautiful, beautiful bag. But enough of rambling, we're gonna go ahead and dig into it. So I'm just gonna unzip the bag. Normally I would have my phone in there, but since I'm at the house, you know, I just have it out. And this is, I think, the iPhone 6. I can't keep up, literally, like, I just lose count because there's so many, like, I don't know. But yeah, this is just the regular size, and I normally just throw it in my purse. Wherever it lands, it lands. So me personally, I'm the type of person that I just don't like a ton of stuff floating around freely in my bag. It happens sometimes, but for the most part, I kind of like to keep everything in different compartments. So the biggest thing that's in my bag is my makeup bag, and it still has the stuff that I was using during summertime, so I need to change it out. But if you guys are interested in seeing what I keep in my makeup bag, then I will link it below because I have already filmed a video on this. So yeah, I need to switch the products out. But yeah, this is my makeup bag, and this bag is from Victoria's Secret, and I got it a few years ago. So on the side of the bag, it just has like two little pouches that purses normally have. So in the first pouch, I just have some gum, and Orbit is by far my favorite. So I think I have like peppermint and winter mint. And as I've told you guys before, whenever you're buying gum, breath mints, whatever it may be, make sure that you get mint and not fruity, because mint will cancel out the stinking breath and the fruity will intensify it. So I always get some type of mint gum, and Orbit is my favorite. So yeah, I have two packs of gum, and then on the other side I just have some little mints, and these are the Altoid mints. They're not the greatest, like, they're super strong, but you know, if you're out eating and you just so happen to be eating onions or something like that, these Altoids will definitely get rid of the stinking breath because they are really strong, like bring tears to your eyes strong. So yeah, these aren't my favorite. They're the peppermint kind, but you know, they'll get rid of that stinking breath. So on the other side, it just has a little zipper pouch. And the first thing that I have is this hand moisturizer. And this is from Soap and Glory. I don't know about you guys, but my hands are always so dry. So I always have to keep some type of hand moisturizer in my bag. And this is the Sugar Crush fragrance, and it smells really, really nice. My hands specifically get dry in this area. So, you know, if I don't have the moisturizer, then I have to take a little spit on my hand and, like, get rid of that. Because ain't nobody trying to walk around with ashy hands. So, yeah, that's the real struggle if you don't have moisturizer. So, yeah, always keep that in my bag. And then I have some ink pens, two of them, nothing special. Then I have another pack of gum, just a backup. And this is also Orbit. It's the winter mint kind. So then in that little pouch, I have my vlogging camera, and this is a Canon G7X. And I'm going to start vlogging again, hopefully. I love this camera because it has this little flip-up screen, and I'm not the greatest at vlogging, so this really helps make sure that I'm in the frame and stuff like that. So love, love, love this camera. I'm going to try to do Vlogmas. I mean, I don't know, maybe. I'm not sure if I'm the type of person who can vlog every single day, but I am going to, you know, attempt to start vlogging again because I just think it'll be nice to kind of bring you guys along with me whenever I'm doing something a little bit interesting. So yeah, look forward for that. Like, I already have a little bit of footage filmed, so there should be a new video going up on Nitra BTV really soon. So the next thing in the pouch is this EOS lip balm, and this is just for any time that my lips are really dry. I love these. A lot of times when I go out, I don't even have on makeup, so I at least want to make sure that my lips ain't cracking or anything like that. Then I just have a pad. You got Kotex, you never know when you're gonna need it, so I always keep a backup in there. Then I have a little perfume. This one's from Scentbird. I am so obsessed with Scentbird. The fragrance that I have is the Marc Jacobs Daisy So Fresh Sorbet, and it smells really, really nice. I just have an obsession with perfume, so I always keep one in my bag. And then I have this little Hershey's Cookies and Cream Bar, like one of the little mini sizes. And then also, I have another perfume. This is a Rollerball. This is Elizabeth and James Nirvana, and it smells absolutely amazing. It smells really, really good, you guys. It's like, it's a really mature fragrance, but it smells really, really nice. So that was everything in the side pockets of the bag. So now we're going to start in the main portion. And the first thing that I have is this little pouch, and this came out of my Neverfull bag. It was just like a little extra piece that came with it. So I love to just keep it with any bag that I carry because it's really convenient. So what I like to keep in here are some phone chargers because I don't know about you guys, but I just don't like for my phone to be dead. So yeah, I have two phone chargers, and then I have like the little thing that you actually plug into the wall, and then I have like the actual car plug charger, and I keep one in my car as well. So I just always want to be prepared. Then I have some change in there, and on this other side I just have like receipts and like gift cards and little coupons. I have this little $10 gift card from Victoria's Secret. I think this expires soon. It expires October the 19th. Let's see what today is. Today's the 18th, so this actually expires tomorrow. So if I want to use it, I better get on it. So then I also have my sunglasses. The ones that I am currently carrying are from Versace, and they look like this. You guys have probably saw me wear them on Snapchat and Instagram, but I really love these. A lot of people ask me about them, but I think they're discontinued. They're the Versace rimless frames, but I'm almost positive they're discontinued. But if I can find them, I will put a link below so you guys can check them out. So then I have my wallet, and I got this from Louis Vuitton a couple of years ago. And seriously, you guys, if you never even thought about like investing in a, you know, a higher end handbag, I would definitely say at least take some thought into getting a more expensive wallet, because for me, I was just buying those that weren't expensive at all, maybe like $20, and I would use my wallet so much that they would tear up really quickly, and I would go through one probably 3 to 6 months. So I was just having to spend $20 and $30 that many times, which adds up. And after you think about it, after you buy so many of those wallets, you could go ahead and get you one that's gonna be really, really great quality. So I've had this one probably 2 years now, and it's really, really nice. So I like it because it opens all the way up and you can see everything that's inside, and it's not like one of those that just barely opens. So yeah, I really, really love this wallet. And then I just have my headphones, and I just keep these in my purse because anytime I go to the gym, I always like to listen to music. So since I always have my phone, I just like to keep these in there so, you know, I can jam out while I'm on the treadmill. And then I also like to keep wipes in my purse for any time that your hands might get sticky or things get messy. I just always like to have some type of wipey. This is the Kleenex Cottonelle. So yeah, just any type of wipe I love to keep in my bag. Then I have my keys, and literally, you guys, my keys are always at the bottom of my purse because my car is just like one of those that just push to start, and anytime it's time to come in the house, then I can never find them because they're always at the bottom. Then I have some makeup remover wipes, I guess just in case I ever need to take off my lipstick or any type of makeup. I just keep these little Equate makeup remover cleansing towelettes. And I like the Equate brand over the MAC. For some reason, the MAC wipes, they would always leave my face feeling really oily, and I just didn't like the way that it left my face feeling. But anyways, so then I have, this is the little Blotterazzi thing that I showed you guys in a haul not too long ago. It's actually made by Beauty Blender. It comes in this really, really cute case. Now, I've actually used this a couple of times and it seems to be pretty good, but I mean, it takes off makeup, I guess, like, or it removes the shine just like any other sponge would. So I don't know if it's really actually worth the $20. I think this is $20. I mean, I think the case that it comes in is really cute, but I don't know. I haven't really used it that many times to let you know if I think it's really, really worth it, but like I said, the case is cute. So we're getting down to the end. I have another pack of Orbit gum. This is the green kind. I don't think I really like this flavor as much, so that's probably why it's at the bottom of my purse. Then I also have this compact from MAC. This is their Studio Fix powder in NC45, and I just like to keep this in my bag in case I'm not wearing any makeup and I decide I want to look presentable, which probably never happens. Like, if I'm without makeup, then you're just gonna have to take me as I am. The only person that I'm gonna be trying to look presentable for is Jesus. So unless you're Jesus, you gotta take me as I am, okay? So then I also have my umbrella in my purse, and this one is from Benefit. I got it when I went to San Francisco not too long ago, and I just like to keep one in there because you don't wanna be the person that gets caught in the rain because you didn't put an umbrella in there. Then I have this large powder brush from Sigma. This should probably be in my makeup bag because it's probably getting all kind of stuff all over it. But yeah, in case I ever decide to sweep that powder over my face, I use that brush. Then I have a peppermint. Let's see. And then I have a liquid lipstick from ColourPop, and this one's in the color Beeper. It's like my all-time favorite nude color now. I really, really love this color. I need to get a backup so I can keep one in my purse and also on my vanity. All right, you guys, so that is everything that was in my bag. It is completely empty now, as you guys can tell. I carry a lot of stuff, but I feel like I've minimized it over the years. Like, I literally used to carry way more, but I think I've minimized it just a little bit. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. If any of you guys have recently filmed a What's in My Bag video, then link it below so I can check it out, because I love checking out you guys' different channels. You guys know that. And I just love interacting with you guys, especially on Snapchat. Like, you guys know, if you're on Snapchat, I like literally have conversations with you guys just on the regular. So if you're not following me on Snapchat, be sure to do so. And also subscribe to my channel so you never miss when I upload. So thank you guys so much for watching this video and always supporting me. I love you guys, and I will talk to you next time. Bye. Hi guys, so I'm back with another video, and this one's going to be a fall makeup tutorial, another one, but this one is more of an everyday look, something that's going to be really, really simple. I wanted to do something that was more suitable for the everyday woman having to go to work or school, and they wanted a very natural look that wouldn't be too extreme or be too hard.